Are you a fan of the Marvel Universe? If yes, here's some trivia for you. Remember that part in the Doctor Strange movie where Doctor Strange goes to Nepal in search of Kamar Taj? Well, all those places are here in Kathmandu. Some of the scenes were shot in Pashupatinath temple, while some other parts were shot in the Swayambhunath temple. The place where I was in the last vlog, I have attached a link in the I button if you want to go over there. The Kamar Taj that has been shown in the movie is actually the Patan Durbar Square in Kathmandu. The ancient royal palace of Patan faces onto the magnificent Durbar Square. This concentrated mass of temples is perhaps the most visually stunning display of Nepali architecture to be seen in Nepal. The reconstruction of temples affected by the 2015 earthquake was going on when I visited, and so the fencing and scaffolding were still there. However, the restoration was well underway and the royal palace housing the museum was open. The Patan Durbar Square is crowded with many notable temples and buildings. The main temples are aligned opposite to the western face of the palace, and the entrance of the temples always face east, that is towards the palace. One of the major attractions of Patan Durbar Square is the museum, which is filled with bronze statues and many, many religious objects. Having visited the Patan Durbar Square, we moved on to the holy Buddhist religious site, Boudhanath. It is actually the largest and the most sacred Tibetan Buddhist site outside of Tibet. The overall shape represents a Buddhist mandala, the path towards enlightenment, as well as the mythical center of the cosmos, Mount Meru. According to Buddhist tradition, this site is said to hold the remains of the Kassapa Buddha, the 27th of the named Buddhas. The place is in the heart of Kathmandu, located in Bodha, named after the stupa itself. The nearby place called Sanghu was the shortest route for trading between Kathmandu and Tibet in ancient times. Due to this reason, you can observe the mixed combination of Nepali locals and Tibetan people in that area. Boudha is a very engrossing and spiritual area where devotees walk more than 3 times a day and chanting holy mantra, Om Mani Padme Hum. During the full moon day, monks are indulged in prayers, singing songs, and number of Buddhists come over to place for visiting. The 5 most promising elements representing Buddha, that is, earth, air, water, fire and space, are comprised in the stupa's architecture. It is believed that thousands of Buddhas incarnated as lamas in Bodha stupa and the rays of Bodhisattva entered stupa in the form of song from heaven and was heard in the sky. Due to this reason, Bodha is viewed with great reverence as are Sangi, Thangi, Duibe, Chodin, etc. A final visit was to the oldest Hindu temple complex in Nepal, which serves as the seat of Nepal's national deity, Lord Pashupatinath. When we arrived at Pashupatinath temple, I did not realize how big it actually was. The long walkway leading to the temple has shops on both sides offering prasad, rudraksh malas and more. Like Boudhanath before, Pashupatinath temple is also a UNESCO World Heritage Site, but is unique in that it is a place important to both Buddhists and Hindus. Indeed, in the main temple, only Hindus or Buddhists are actually allowed in. Before entering the main temple premises, you are expected to remove your shoes, and there is a facility outside that provides the service for free. Pashupatinath temple darshan timings are from 4 a.m. to 12 noon and again from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. in the night. The temple stays closed from noon to 5 p.m. every day, and the aarti timings are in the evening from 6 to 7:30 p.m. We explored even more of the temples and eventually headed back to the main temple, where, as it turned out, several cremation rites were taking place. Out of respect, I did not take any pictures. There are many legends describing as to how the temple of Lord Alok Pashupatinath came to existence. One legend says that Lord Shiva and Parvati once took the form of an antelope and sported unknown in the forest on the Bagmati River's east bank. The gods later caught up with him and, grabbing him by one of his horns, forced him to resume his divine form. The broken horn was worshipped as a Shiva Linga, but over time it was buried and lost. Centuries later, astonished herdsmen found one of his cows showering the earth with milk. Digging deep at the site, he discovered the divine linga of Pashupatinath. Photography and videography is strictly not allowed inside the main temple, and only Hindus and Buddhist people are allowed to enter. I did not record or click any pictures, but being a Hindu, it was really a very spiritual experience for me and my parents. We wandered around the temple grounds, even more surprised by how huge it was, before finally deciding to head back to our hotel. The next day, we had to leave for Pokhara, another beautiful town of Nepal.